5 is going to destroy this place with thermonuclear missiles. All right, this is Jeremiah 50 and 21. It says, go up against the land of Marathim. What's that word, Marathim? When you look it up, it means double rebellion, man. That's Babylon the Great. And that's the reason why this place is going to be destroyed in such a manner that it's going to be destroyed in, man. Okay, you got Lil Nas X. This nigga can twerk on Satan. That's all good, you know. But, the brother was saying in the video, Paul Pierce, he's just hanging out with women, you know. They ain't got no clothes on. He's, you know, hanging out with him, being a man. And then that's condemned here in Babylon the Great. But two women can be on stage on national TV, and they can scissor each other, man. You know, you got a thing that's pretty much in charge of the health for the whole country, man. But that's celebrated and praised, you know. That's double rebellion, man. Go up against the land of Marathim, even against it, and against the inhabitants of Peacock, waste and utterly destroy after them, saith the Lord Yah, Bashem Yahweh Shai, and do according to all that I have commanded thee. A sound of battle is in the land and of great destruction, and Yah, Bashem Yahweh Shai is going to bring great destruction here upon Babylon the Great. Okay? 200 million missiles to completely destroy this place from off the face of the earth, man. And as a result of those missiles hitting America, the whole earth is going to shake, man. That's a heavy destruction. It says a sound of battle is in the land and of great destruction. How is the hammer of the whole earth cut asunder and broken? How is Babylon become a desolation among the nations? Because this place is the top place on the face of the earth, man. And in 1 hour, like the scriptures say, this place is going to be completely destroyed. You know, the way that, Babylon was built up and the power that it still has today, you would never think that it's going to be destroyed in the manner that it's going to be destroyed in, man. All right. Even if another, nation rises up as being the top nation on earth, you don't expect all the buildings to be destroyed, man. You don't expect, this place to be completely leveled and turned into a desert. These people ain't expecting that. All right. It says, how was the hammer of the whole earth cut asunder and broken? How has Babylon become a desolation among the nations? I have laid a snare for thee, and thou art also taken, O Babylon, and thou was not aware. See, that Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai put your ass in a trap. Okay? You have no idea what's going on. Part of that trap is these other nations that Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is putting on the level. And you being in your pride, you're going to go to war with these nations because you want to maintain your hegemony. You want to maintain your influence over the earth. But guess what? Your time is up. All right, but that pride is going to lead you to go to war with these nations, and Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is going to allow these nations to overtake you and completely destroy you, man. Okay, another snare that the Heavenly Father set for you was laying down his people for you to conquer, man. He knew you was going to go overboard with it, so he used that so he can jack your ass up in the days that we're getting ready to come into, man. It says, I have laid a snare for thee, and thou art also taken, O Babylon, and thou was not aware. Thou art found and also caught because thou hast striven against the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. You fighting against the Heavenly Father by establishing these different customs down here, man. By being against what the Heavenly Father stands for and being for everything that the Most High is against. You're an enemy of the Lord. Verse 23, it says, the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, hath opened his armory and hath brought forth the weapons of his indignation. For this is the work of the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai of hosts, in the land of the Chaldeans. All right? And what's the Lord's armory? Those thermonuclear missiles, man. Which the Most High is going to use to finish his work upon the land of the Chaldeans, which is America. And his work is to completely destroy this place from off the face of the earth, man. And everybody's going to be fully aware of why the Heavenly Father did these things, man. Why America got overthrown in the manner that it got overthrown in. Because of the wickedness that's going on here. This is Jeremiah 49, and I'll start at 13. It says, for I have sworn by myself, saith the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, that Basra shall become a desolation. And Basra is talking about America. Okay, Basra was the capital of ancient Edom. The modern-day capital of Edom is America. sworn by myself, saith the Lord Yah, Bashem Yahweh Shai, that Bozra shall become a desolation, a reproach, a waste, and a curse, and all the cities thereof shall be perpetual waste, which proves this isn't talking about the ancient Bozra, because the ancient Bozra was in itself a city. Okay? America has multiple cities here, so all the cities here in America is going to be destroyed right along with it. Verse 14, it says, I have heard a rumor from the Lord, Yah, Bashem Yahweh Shai, and an ambassador is sent unto the heathen, saying, gather ye together and come up against her and rise up to the battle. And the Most High has multiple ambassadors out here now, stirring these other nations up, man. Preparing them to go to war against Esau, Edom, against Babylon the Great. Verse 15, it says, for lo, I will make thee small among the heathen and despised among many. You see that happening, man. There was a meeting that America took part in with China. It took place in Alaska, and China pretty much cursed them out, man. You know, and America pretty much they got belittled, you know, on the world stage. Okay, fulfilling this prophecy here, man. It says, for lo, I will make thee small among the heathen. So America has become insignificant, man. Okay, these other nations, they ready to destroy this place. It says, for lo, I will make thee small among the heathen and despised among men. Thy terribleness hath deceived thee in the pride of thine heart, O thou that dwellest in the clefts of the rock. And what's your terribleness? Your military might. Because you actually believe that your military is going to get you out of any conflict that you find yourself in, man. But you see what's going on with the military here in Babylon. The military is being feminized, man. Okay? Femininity is not an attribute of war. All right? If you have a feminine army, you're going to be destroyed. All right? It says, O thou that dwellest in the clefts of the rock, that holdest the height of the hill, though thou shouldest make thy nest as high as the eagle, I will bring thee down from thence, saith the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Also, Edom shall be a desolation. Everyone that goeth by shall be astonished and hiss at all the plagues thereof. When they see this place, they're going to bug out, man. You know, how did this place, you know, get destroyed like this, man? What did these people have to do for the Lord to bring a destruction like this upon it, man? Okay? You go into the road, it was sodomites here, it was transformers here. You know, they were false idol worshiping. They had the nation of Israel in slavery. And the list goes on, man. Okay? Verse 18, it says, as in the overthrow of Sodom and Gomorrah, and the neighbor cities thereof, saith the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, no man shall abide there, neither shall a son of man dwell in it. So the Lord is going to completely wipe this place from off the face of the earth, man. And the destruction that Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is going to bring upon this place is every bit deserved. All right? And you see the wickedness that's going on here, man. There's no better way for Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai to destroy this place and make an example out of this place, man. All right? This is Sirach 36, and I'll start at 3. It says, lift up thy hand against strange nations, and let them see thy power. And you're going to see the power, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. You're going to see the power that you wanted to make your enemy, man. Okay? It says, lift up thy hand against the strange nations, and let them see thy power. Part of the power, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, is his ability to rain nuclear missiles on your ass, man. Okay? He's literally going to commandeer those missiles and shoot them on Babylon the Great, man. It says, as thou was sanctified in us before them, so be thou magnified among them before us. And let them know thee as we have known thee, that there is no power but only thou, O power. And you people going to understand this, man. Okay, especially you Edomites here in Babylon the Great. You going to understand that Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is the only power that reigns down here upon the earth. All these little gods you worship, Baphomet, Baal, okay, Molech, them is just idols, man. They ain't going to be able to save you from the wrath of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. They're going to get burned up too, okay? You don't know and understand why Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is to be feared, man. See, we already know. We already have experienced the judgments and the power of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. We was coming out of the wilderness, okay, when we was in the wilderness coming out of the land of Egypt. You know, when we was in our land, the Most High brought those judgments upon us. And even more recently, when we went into slavery under your ass, man. That was the work of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. there is no power but only thou, O power. Show new signs and make other strange wonders. Glorify thy hand and thy right arm, which is Jehoshaphat, that they may set forth thy wondrous works. Rise up indignation and pour out wrath, and the Most High is going to pour his wrath out in the form of those thermonuclear missiles here upon Babylon the Great, man. Okay? And that shows you how pissed off the Heavenly Father is to have stored up 200 million missiles to destroy this place, man. Okay? And one nuclear warhead caused a devastating amount of destruction, man. So how pissed off does the Lord have to be to have 200 million of these things waiting just for, you know, when Babylon reaches that point of no return, the Most High completely destroys this place, man. Okay, once they pass that red line, the Lord shoot those missiles on this place, man. How pissed off is Yahabashim Yahushah to send that much fire and destruction upon this place, man? It says, rise up indignation and pour out wrath, take away the adversary and destroy the enemy, and you're going to be taken away. Your rulership is going to be taken away, and you're going to be destroyed, man. And once this place is taken out, you ain't never coming back into power, man. Okay? Once the Most High completely is done away with you, you ain't going to rise up again. All right? This is the last scripture. I'll wrap it up on this. This is Ezekiel 35 and 14. It says, thus saith the Lord, Yahabashim Yahushai, power, when the whole earth rejoiceth, I will make thee desolate, as thou didst rejoice at the inheritance of the house of Israel, because it was desolate, so will I do unto thee. Thou shalt be desolate, O Mount Seir, and all Idumea, even all of it, and they shall know that I am the Lord, Yahabashim Yahushai. Okay, and the Most High has already pronounced judgment upon this place. Okay, and the closer, you know, or the longer you go on, okay, the longer this society, you know, remains established, the closer we get to that destruction, man. Okay, and the more wicked that this place gets, and the more justified Yahabashim Yahushai is on raining those 200 million nuclear missiles down on this place, man. Okay? Expect this place to get more wicked, man. All right? And the Lord is going to rain all those. He's going to empty out his whole arsenal, man. We just read that he opened his armory up. Every single missile that's been created is going to be used. The majority of them falling down upon Babylon the Great. Okay? So with that, I'm going to give all praises to Yahweh, Bahashim Yahushai, Bahashim Arahakwadash, double honors to the elders and apostles, a great millstone, Shalom.